Do you know a single compromised device on your network can give hackers access to your entire system? What if I told you there is a simple solution to stop that? Welcome to today's video. This is MD Joshimuddin with you all, and you are watching Learn Cybersecurity BD, where we will dive into network segmentation and why it's crucial for cybersecurity. Network segmentation is like central zone within a network. Think of it as dividing a big house into separate rooms, each with its own lock. If an intruder gets into your room, they can't easily access to the others. For example, separating your IoT devices like smart TV and cameras from critical business systems can prevent network breaches. You may know nowadays IoT is randomly getting hacked by hackers. Before I go to show you the network segmentation in MikroTik router, let me tell you what network segmentation will do for securing your total network. It reduces the attack surface, limit how far hackers can go, prevent lateral movement, contain attacks in isolated segments, enhance monitoring, easier to detect suspicious activity in smaller zones. Imagine if a hacker breaches to your guest Wi-Fi without segmentation, they could not access sensitive business files. But with segmentation, they are stuck in the guest zone.
So, now you know the network segmentation and the importance of network segmentation to prevent intrusion. So, we are diving into our MikroTik router to prevent those. Get started.
Look at the screen carefully. I have made a network where multiple segments of individual network has joined in a broad network. On this, you may note I have separated three segments with three IP series for separation of networks. Though those segments internally connected with a switch, but logically I will block them to route one to others because I like to set them individual segment of networks. If any hacking activities will occur on one of the segments, the hacker will not find the other segments and other segment will remain safe.
So, at first we came here to create VLANs. We came our MikroTik router and going to our terminal. We are going to our interface / interface VLAN, and from VLAN we will create a VLAN. Add name is equal to VLAN 10 and VLAN ID is equal to VLAN 10. VLAN ID is equal to 10, and interface will be our Ether 2, as I like to use Ether 2 here, so my interface will be Ether 2. Then if you go to my VLAN here, interface VLAN, that is the VLAN I created earlier. So I copied this and create another VLAN for VLAN 20. I'll give name the VLAN 20 here. Done. Okay, I'll create another VLAN for another segment. So I copied this and VLAN 30, and VLAN ID will be 30. Okay, that's it. I have created three VLANs here. So this is my three VLANs. Next, I will go to assign IP for those VLANs that we are created here. Assign VLAN, assign VLAN IP. I came back to my terminal and we'll go to IP address and add an address for my VLAN 10. Address 192.168.102.1/24 will be my IP series for VLAN 10. Interface is equal to VLAN 10. That's it. and I like to make a comment for this, and a comment will be, segment VLAN 10. That's it, hit enter. After that, I will see in IP address, here I have created IP for VLAN 10. I will copy this and make for another VLAN. Here I will use 103.1/24, and my network IP will be 103, and it will be VLAN 20. Done. I copy the IP for another VLAN, so I'll make it 104.1/24, and VLAN will be 30. That's it. I have assigned 3 VLANs IP here. Oops. It will be 103.1/103.0. Okay. For VLAN 20. I'll copy it again for VLAN 3 here. For VLAN 30. That's it. Now we have created 3 VLANs and 3 segment of IP for our 3 VLANs. Separated IP for individual VLANs. Now we have to create VLAN rule for individual VLANs. So I'm back to my terminal and I like to go to my firewall, IP firewall filter, add chain. Have to create a chain for accept of my individual VLANs. Chain is equal to add chain is equal to forward. Action is equal to accept, and interface will be VLAN 10. That is, I am accepting all route for individual my VLAN 10. Out interface will be VLAN 10. In interface 10 and out interface 10. That is, in interface and out interface are the same for this route. Okay, then hit enter. Now I will go to firewall rule. Here is the rule that I have created just now, and I will copy this rule and make a comment for this VLAN 10 accept. VLAN 10 accept will be done, and after that I will copy rule for the VLAN other VLANs. Sorry, here is noise, some airplane noise. VLAN 10 to 20 accept VLAN 10 to 10, VLAN 20 to 20, VLAN 30 to 30. That is, in interface 30, out interface 30 accept. It will accept in out interface of individual VLANs. That is, if my segment VLAN 30 in and out will be segment 30. VLAN 30 accept. VLAN, this is VLAN for 20 and 30. All done. 10, 20, 30, I will drop it above of 30. That is for 20. That's it. Now I will go to block of individual segments, that is each segment of VLAN will not allow another VLANs. To separate the route, I have to create rule here. So I have copied the rule. IP firewall filter chain forward action is going to drop. In interface is equal to VLAN 10 and outer interface will be VLAN 10. That is VLAN 10 to VLAN 20 will be dropped. If anyone like to go to VLAN 10 to 20, it will drop all routes. Okay. If I go to the firewall, then I have created the rule. So I'll copy it 10 to 20 action dropped. That is 10 to 20 route, all route will be dropped. Here in interface 10 and out interface 20 will be dropped. So I'll copy this and make it for another VLANs. VLAN 10 to VLAN 30 will be dropped. So VLAN out interface will be 30, action drop. Okay, I'll copy this again and here I will copy the rule again and VLAN 30 to 20, make a comment, we'll copy it and this will be VLAN 20 to VLAN 30, VLAN 20 to VLAN 30 action drop. So that's it, that's the VLAN rule for block individual segments. I am dropping all the packets from 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to any other segments. I have separated all route individuals. So anyone like to hacking or spoofing, it will be dropped another VLANs and every segment individually disable all routes to another VLANs. Now I will go to NAT rule, source NAT. I will create a source NAT for internet. Every segment use my internet. So I am going to NAT rule creation and here I will masquerade all the traffic for outgoing. Source NAT action interface will be my Ethernet 1. That is my which port has connected to my internet from my ISP. So I'll select this and make it OK for internet using. Look at this. I have selected the interface here 1 and masquerade it. That is my rules that I have created for VLANs internet using purpose.
Here we have created VLANs for individual networks. Here we have created 3 VLANs. Created rule for individual VLAN transaction and we have created filter rule to block one VLAN to another VLAN. That means one segment to another segment. There will not be any route to one route, one segment to another segment. And lastly, we have created NAT rule for confirmation of internet. So we have created 4 rules here. Now if you get this helpful or if you don't understand regarding this can knock me in my social media. And if you get this helpful, please subscribe my channel. Till then, take care. Goodbye.